have had the opportunity to speak with the lead detective on this case, Detective Teresa Sprague. We do have new leads that have come in.
The city of Orlando argued police do have new leads in the disappearance of Jennifer Kessie in 2006, and for that reason, they cannot provide most of the confidential information in the investigative case file. Her parents, Drew and Joyce Kessie, sued to force the city to release the files under the state's public records law. The family is willing to pay more than $18,000 for copies, but argue against the city's claim that most of the information is exempt.
And virtually every piece of information that is not a time and date at the top has been blacked out.
The judge indicated the city will have to prove its investigation is active.
Does the city have a reasonable good faith anticipation of securing an arrest or prosecution in the foreseeable future after 13 years?
With that, he ordered OPD to turn over the case files to the new judge hearing the case by noon January 12th for a court-only review, which appeared to satisfy the Kessies.
Well, I would hope that those leads will then be followed up and worked through.
We know mistakes are made. We've made mistakes. But that has absolutely nothing to do with this right now. The number one thing that we're trying to do is find Jennifer.
The judge will be inspecting the Orlando Police investigative records less than 2 weeks before the 13th anniversary of Jennifer Kessie's disappearance. In Orange County, Greg Fox, West 2 News.